how are we going to do this? Are you going to ask me questions or do I just talk?
Whichever you prefer.
That's the couch, right?
The sofa, yes.
Do I sit or do I lie? What do most people do?
Most people sit.
Right.
We were talking about friendship.
Yes, 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 of course.
A particular long-standing friendship.
Can we just talk about sex?
If you prefer.
No. It was a joke. I'm sorry. I want to talk about love, friendship, and deceit. I want to talk about the fact that up until 3 days ago, there were three people. Friends. Best friends. Since our first day at school. Frank, Daniel, and me. We just looked out for each other. Or at least I looked out for them. That's the way it's always been. Anyway, three people whose lives were okay. Not perfect, but okay. But that was 3 days ago. Daniel was in the States finalizing some record deal and was on his way home.
Mate, what can I say? You rock, mate.
I know.
I'm very excited.
Thanks a lot,
Chuck,
Dan.
We'll speak.
Take care.
Bye.
He's this hotshot executive in the music business. You know the type. Reinvented the 70s single-handed, only flies first class, hits on every good-looking woman in sight, which always leads to problems with Frank. Frank. What can I tell you about Frank? He's a penniless, out-of-work actor consumed with envy for Daniel, and I'm the one stuck in the middle. There'd been some competition over a French actress, and Frank wouldn't stop talking about it on the way to dinner that night.
Nikki, the agent, calls me up, right? She's got this French actress coming over from Paris. She's throwing this big dinner party in her honor. She needs men. So she wants me to bring Daniel, because she's read some article in some fucking magazine about how fucking eligible he is. Right, so we get to this restaurant, and this French actress is like this bombshell, right? So Nikki takes me, and places me next to Bombshell Woman, place of honor. And the conversation through the evening is really flowing, like a really, you know. And it turns out that she's got this break in her schedule coming up the following weekend, and she wants me to give her a call. So, next day, I give her a call, no reply. Day after that, give her a call, no reply. Next day, Nikki phones me up to tell me that Bombshell Woman has gone to Venice with fucking Daniel. Now, answer me a question. Is that the behaviour of a friend?
Well,
because I tell you, the only reason he was interested is because I was interested.
Frank, don't be so paranoid. What do you have?
So I try and convince myself the stuff you always go on about, how we're the closest friends we'll ever have. You want to know the truth? I hate him. I hate him, he hates me. There's a pleasing kind of symmetry to it. Both hate each other, the kind of commitment you only get from childhood friends. Next time I see him, I'm gonna break his nose, and break his fucking jaw. Jesus Christ, you know the truth.
He went on and on in the way that only Frank can. The acting thing was getting him down. He hadn't worked in years, and he was in a bad way. I needed to talk to Daniel, but Daniel was in Minneapolis and about to cause us even more trouble. It all began with something as simple as a trolley.
The white zone is for immediate loading and unloading of passengers only. No parking.
Sorry, that's mine.
I beg your pardon?
It's my cart.
No, because I saw it all the way back
there. No, I just put $1.50 in the machine.
Really?
Yes.
Well, then it's yours.
Thank you.
Hey, let me help you with that.
Thank
please.
You. I always heard you British guys were gentlemen. You are British, aren't you?
English, actually, yeah.
English, actually. That's where I'm going, London.
Uh-huh.
Yep. Thanks. I like the bags. You got the whole set, huh? Sharp.
Do you see that woman over there with the yellow top on? I want you to upgrade her ticket and put her in the seat next to me.
I'm sorry, I can't do that.
Why not?
She's on a different flight.
A different... But she said she was going to London.
Well, she is, but 2 hours later, and rather crucially in this case, I think, with a different airline.
Oh, come on. You people, you have deals with each other. You can fix something.
In this case, you need to buy a fresh ticket. That's $5,000. One way. Now, are you sure you don't want to think about this? You know, airports do funny things to people.
I've made up my mind.
In that case, you want to bring the lady over, sir. I need to see her passport.
No, you don't understand. This has to be a coincidence, right? She mustn't know I did this.
So what do you want me to do, sir?
We'll make up some excuse. About the flight being full, or there's a special offer, or maybe this airline just picked her.
Just picked her.
Here's your seat, madam. Champagne? Here come the freebies. Just that word, complimentary, you know, it really gets me going. It's like if drinks are on the house, my first thought isn't, oh, how fabulous, how wonderful. No, it's how many. Not that I'm an alcoholic. Now, my ex-husband, Jerry.
Would you excuse me one moment?
Something had gone wrong.
Daniel needed to make a decision. At the time, it was about first class or economy. Not something you'd think would change the rest of our lives.
But a lot can happen in 3 days. And in 3 days, it's all fallen apart.
Hi.
This is weird, huh?
It's... I'm Martha, by the way.
Daniel. Hello.
Daniel with the matching bag.
That's me.
Oh, do you want to hear something incredible?
Yeah, sure.
I'm standing in line, you know, waiting to check in, when this man in uniform, he walks up to me and he's like, "Congratulations, madam. You are the 100,000th passenger to fly on this airline, this route, this year."
Really?
Yes. And to mark the occasion, a completely different airline would like to fly you first class to London.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Do you have any idea how much those seats cost?
Remind me.
$5,000. I mean, what kind of a jackass would waste money like that, you know? Oh, I told him to give me the cash, you know, but he wouldn't. So I sold the ticket to a woman who couldn't wait to give me $2,000 for it.
$2,000?
Plus, you know, my seat's fine. I feel good. I feel great. And how do you feel?
Great.
Oh, just can't keep away from each other.
Yeah.
The captain just said we've got a tailwind, which means we'll be in London about half an hour early.
Oh,
which is,
yeah.
Which is great.
Yeah.
Someone meeting you there?
Uh-uh.
Do you know anyone in London?
No.
Is it your first time out of the States?
Maybe.
So why London?
Paris was $300.
Oh?
L.A. was $188. Mexico City was $350. Seattle was $130. London was $99.
Excuse me. Were you coming to London because it was $99?
Yeah. It seemed like a good place to start.
Start what?
The rest of my life.
You mean you're never going back?
Nothing to go back for, except working like a mule, an apartment I can't afford, and a man who used me to amuse his friends.
Oh, wow.
You think I'm crazy?
No, of course I don't.
Well, actually, yes, I do. How much money did you bring? Do you mind me asking?
$35.
$35. They'd have put you on the first plane back.
Yeah, right. Even with a nice British gentleman like yourself around, Daniel.
Mm-hmm.
The ticket, Daniel.
What ticket?
What ticket? You didn't expect me to believe that story, did you?
The 100...
Please, I'm flattered, really. No one's ever done anything like that for me before. Thank you. Plus, now I have $2,035.
Thank you.
conversation earlier, I don't think you're crazy at all. I work 70 hours a week, and I earn a fortune. And you know how big my flat is? 3,000 square feet. And the day after I moved in, I paid half a dozen people I'd never met before to decorate it. And one of the rooms, they called the library. And they filled it full of books, thousands of books on every subject. And they're all secondhand. You know why?
It was cheaper?
No. And so it looks like they've been read.
Huh.
See, I have the home of a widely read, widely traveled, deeply interesting man with taste.
And that's not you?
No.
Not even the interesting bit? You know what you should do? You should just pack up and clear out. Bring things back from your travels, you know, putting the books up one by one after you've read them.
Just pack up and go, huh?
To hell with the consequences, you know.
Yeah, one day I might just do that.
I shouldn't be doing this, okay, but there's this hotel my company has an arrangement with, and as a welcome to London and a token of goodwill, I'd like you to stay there on your first night.
No, you know I can't accept
it. What? No string. Please. And you have to join me for lunch tomorrow.
That's the catch.
You think that's the catch? Oh. Many people will be delighted by that.
Passport, please, sir.
So that's the address of the hotel, okay, and here's my card.
Daniel with the matching bags. Cute.
Does it say that on the card?
No.
So you ring me tomorrow, yeah?
Oh, yeah, I won't forget.
You won't forget?
Uh-huh, first thing. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Passport, please, sir.
Oh.
Thank you.
Yeah, has she arrived? Oh, excellent. Look, I want you to get a bouquet and send it up to her room. Would you do that? No preferences. No, I'm sure it'll be beautiful. Thank you. Bye.
What? Does he think I'm blind? It's right there on page 2 of the contract. So tell him to sign it and get it over here by lunchtime. Right, okay. Bye.
Martha Dowling. She's not a client, is she?
No, not exactly, no.
This hotel bill mysteriously found its way into company expenses. I was about to authorize it and then realized you'd obviously made a mistake and were intending to settle it yourself.
Yeah, no, I was. Of course I was.
Champagne for two at midnight.
For two? It was unprecedented. Daniel, being given the runaround by a woman. You couldn't imagine what followed. Phone calls, more phone calls. Suddenly, Daniel needed us after all.
I love my mother. I love my mother.
Frank, come on, please.
I can't believe we've got this audition in 2 hours.
Frank, he sounded desperate.
What the hell is that?
Oh, please, come on.
Christ. Well, I'm going to break his nose. First his nose, then his fucking jaw.
Get this. He even offered to pay for the meal.
Fuck.
See ya. Bye.
Hi, Laurence. You okay, mate?
Yeah, very well.
Hi, Twinkle Toes.
Let's go.
This way. Come on.
Frank, don't be so childish.
This has never happened to me before. I can't concentrate on work. I can't eat. Do I look pale?
I can't believe we had to meet about this.
Frank, she was giving me the signals, okay? A man can tell.
Yeah, right, like champagne at midnight with somebody else. You're a musk magnet,
Daniel. If you'd met her, you'd understand.
I've been trying to understand since we got here. So you meet some girl at an airport, you get a big rush of blood to your head. It costs you a fortune. Because she treats you like a jerk, you immediately fall in love with her. You're surrounded on a daily basis by the most beautiful single women in this town. You're voted one of the city's most eligible bachelors, and you fall for this vagrant. If humiliation is what you desire, I'll arrange it gladly any time. Be my pleasure. But don't let this...
Martha
ruin your life. I was a big attraction anyway. You fuck her.
Oh, I can't believe he said that.
Well, she's obviously fucking everyone else.
She's different, Frank. She's different from anybody I've ever met. Mm. Laurence, help me out here. You understand these things. Describe for Frank the perfect woman. Please.
I'm sorry.
Jeez, please.
No, you're just being sad.
The perfect woman. Well, she'd have a light in her eyes.
Yes.
And an infectious, wonderful smile.
Yes.
Yes.
Talking to her, you've told her things you've never told anyone.
I did.
Began
I did
to see things in a way you've never seen them before.
Yes, yes.
Leaving her, you knew somehow things had irreversibly changed, would never be the same again.
Yes, 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 yes. Exactly, thank you.
So he didn't fuck her?
Of course I didn't sleep with her. Apart from the fact that I don't sleep with anybody on a first date, okay? We were on an aeroplane together.
Everyone has sex on aeroplanes.
What are you talking about? Where?
Where? In the cockpit, in the toilet. I did it between London and Amsterdam.
London and Amsterdam's 40 minutes. They didn't even let you out of your seat.
I didn't say it was great sex. It was a rush job.
Uh-huh, and how did you do it? Standing up or sitting down?
What do you want, the fucking video? What's the matter with you?
Hey, got Florence.
Hmm?
You okay?
Yeah, fine.
Yeah, you're right, Flo. A bit pale.
Eyes, nothing.
What's your opinion on all this, mate?
My opinion. I was just thinking the fact that she hasn't called you doesn't necessarily mean she's not interested.
You don't think?
No. Plus, we should consider the fact that most women that meet you do find you very attractive.
Not all of them.
I see no reason why this one should be any different. She may have just lost your card.
She may have lost my card.
I may be walking around London right now wishing she knew where to
find you. You see, that is friendship.
Yeah, yeah.
That's the way I see it.
I hadn't even thought of the card. Thank you, Laurence. Thank you. I feel much better now.
Thank you.
Split this three ways.
We bollocks. It's over 100 quid.
So?
So I can't afford that. You suggested this yucked up overpriced dump. You can fucking pay.
Frank, please, if you can't afford it, then stay at home, honestly, because this happens every time. It's embarrassing. Thank you. Keep the change.
Thank you, sir.
Maybe if you didn't piss away what little money you have on cheap wine and space invaders.
Piss away what little money I have on yuppie, uptight, posing parlors.
I swear to God, I'm going to punch his lights out.
Yeah, dream on, sad boy. Touch me one thing, he does.
Oh, shut up, both of you. You really want to hit each other. Just get it over and done with. Anything but talking about it all the time.
Gives me a headache.
It was your fault. Let's go. Come on, get it. Laurence. Bye-bye.
See you.
Sorry.
I'll see you when I see you.
Bye.
Taxi!
Actually, look, I've been meaning to speak to you about the actress.
Yeah, don't.
Well, it's just Nikki mentioned how upset you were, so I thought...
I'm not upset.
You know, Laurence was concerned enough about your condition to drive all the way out to the airport to speak to me about you. Because your behavior recently has been a little crazy, okay? You want my opinion? You should go out there. You should do this audition. You should get a life. And maybe then, you wouldn't be such a pain in the ass.
Taxi!
City, please.
I love my mother.
I love my mother deeply, but then she smokes, she drinks, she quite openly lives with that novelist.
It's much too soft.
But then she...
Harder.
Smokes, she drinks. She quite openly lives with that novelist.
They're always banning her name about in the papers, and I'm sick of it!
Okay, just go again.
I love my mother.
I love my mother deeply. But then she smokes, she drinks, she quite openly lives with that novelist. Is it so? Shit.
Though sometimes what prompts me is just ordinary mortal egotism, I start to regret
that my mother is a well-known actor.
Francis McKeown.
Papa's got a head like a ping pong ball. Papa's got a head like a ping pong ball. Papa's got a head like a ping pong ball. Like a ping pong ball. Papa's got a head like a ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ping pong, ball.
Okay. And next?
Larry.
Uncle. What could be sillier or more hopeless than the position I found myself in often enough? Solid rows of celebrities sitting in her drawing room.
Good. Okay, let's go to the next one. What is it? Frank McKeown? What do you mean he's gone?
Did you know if you walk through this park, you'd get a unique history of England, Oh, yeah. It says if you go north, you see the Houses of Parliament, right? Telling us that this is a democracy. If you go west, you see the Queen's Guards reminding us that this is a monarchy. If you look east, you see the flags of the Commonwealth reminding us that this was once an empire. And if you look south, you get water, reminding us that this is an island. Did you know that the city of London is built on ancient Roman burial grounds?
No, didn't know that, no.
Oh, yeah. There's over 150 different languages spoken in London, and that the residential population is 8 million, rising to 10 million in the summertime. 10 million people.
A lot of people.
Yep. Especially when you're just looking for one. One in 10 million. Sir? Can I have a sip of your drink? I'm out. Thank you. I'm Martha, by the way.
I know.
No,
you're Martha. You're American, and you're looking for someone that you think that you know that you're in love with because you feel it right here, don't you?
Actually, it was here.
Here.
Here. It's like a thunderbolt.
A thunderbolt.
Mm-hmm.
Right. What does that feel like? Just for my education, what does that feel like to be struck by a thunderbolt?
It happened in the airport. Carrying my bags, you know. Crowds everywhere, confusion, you know, and then all of a sudden there was no more noise. There was just him, and there was me. And I felt sick, you know? And it makes me so angry, because that was not the plan. The plan was a future of irresponsible liaisons and roads paved in gold. The plan was not waking up alone in a hotel room lonely and in love booking the first flight home.
Well, you're going home?
Yeah, there's a flight that leaves tomorrow night. Isn't that pathetic, huh? 24 hours in a brand new life and I completely choke. Now my only hope is that when I go home, no one will even notice that I left. You know, that way I can get my job back in my apartment. Oh my God. That whiskey really hit me.
Yeah, me too.
We're gonna get soaked.
I really should know by now.
Oh.
Listen, I don't suppose you'd consider taking a coffee with a certain pathetic, spineless drunk.
They say like attracts like, right?
They do, don't they? Tea.
Yeah, I'll have tea. Here.
Two teas, please, mate.
There you are, son.
Hello?
Yeah, it's me. Me?
I've got her.
What do you mean, who? Her! Daniel's American!
And?
What do you mean, got her? Well, eating out of my hand. You know, pupils dilating, kind of got her.
Frank, tell me, where are you now?
In the cafe, in the park. I can't wait to tell Daniel I am really going to enjoy this.
Frank, listen to me.
I haven't got time for a moral discussion. Florence, I just want to tell some of the good news.
It was the worst thing that could have happened.
And with the destructive mood Frank was in, left alone to seduce her. Well, you can imagine how I felt.
You know, your face is so familiar to me. You look like somebody.
And my face is probably familiar because as a child, I was a successful working actor.
Wow.
Yeah, and it all fell apart. That's a super bad life, you know. I occasionally get whatever happened to column written about me in the newspapers. Every couple of Christmases, they rerun some of my old films. I get a whole new batch of love letters from six-year-old girls. Very big with six-year-old girls.
That's it? You don't get love letters from anyone else?
Well, why?
Why? I don't know. You're funny. You know, you have a nice smile. Someone might be missing out.
Where's Mr. 1 in 10 million now? Forgotten all about him, haven't you?
That's not true.
Yes, it is. You were sitting there and you were thinking, gosh, yes, this man is okay. It's better than I thought.
Well, you think when a man and a woman meet each other, that's the only thing that goes through their minds?
Huh? Of course. Yeah, when they're attracted to one another. In fact, most people are attracted to just about everybody. This perfect partner bollocks is just a hoax of physical, chemical impossibility. You know why? Mm. My perfect partner is me.
You.
Me with breasts.
Okay.
The perfect relationship. You would like the same food, like the same music. The sex would be great.
What is the point of all this?
The point is there is no one in 10 million.
You don't think so, huh?
Absolutely not.
Then we'll agree to differ.
Oh, well, whatever you say.
Nice meeting you.
Yeah.
Superstars in the room, private movie. Excuse me, sorry, you haven't paid your bill.
Didn't she? She.
Right.
Oh, no, I'll be back in about half an hour. Sleep in the
car.
He says she has never seen. I haven't got any money. The kiss and tell of it all. I'll be back for the change later. She's so pretty. Her hair is made. Look on the
bright side. You see, you've still got 24 hours to be as irresponsible as you like.
Look, Frank, we had a cup of tea, all right? I think we should just go our separate ways.
Yeah, look, we could always swap, you see. You stay here, I go to Minneapolis, wherever. Have you got hot running water? If you have, it's a damn sight more than I've got.
I appreciate the effort, really, but,
look,
you know.
Whatever the circumstances of your life, they could not be as depressing as mine.
Ah! I wouldn't bet on it.
Okay, try me.
Come on.
I live in a damp, single-story kennel. My windows need repairing.
Mm-hmm.
My gas leaks.
Uh-huh. I live on the 16th floor of a housing project, okay? I sleep to the sound of police helicopters and gunfire.
Okay, parents, I don't have any. Well, not that talk to me.
Oh, okay. My father died when I was 3 and my mother left me to become a Seventh-day Adventist.
Okay, in the last few hours, I have blown the biggest job opportunity I'll probably ever have in years.
Oh, this past year alone, I applied for 13 jobs, none called back, and my wage was cut to $1.80 an hour.
In the last month, I have been arrested and spent 3 nights in jail after police found me unconscious in the streets.
What?
You know, I mean, it's... No, you roll your eyes and everything, you pretend you disapprove, but the fact is, you like me more than you did an hour ago.
You're insane. Absolutely.
No, I'd go further than that. I would actually say that you were developing quite a powerful little crush on me, aren't you?
Yeah.
You disagree?
Absolutely.
All right. Well, why are you holding my hand?
I did not do that.
Well, I didn't.
You did.
No. I love this place. It's so full of hypocrites. Look at that bloke pretending he's interested in the paintings. Look at him, look at him. Oh, look at this one. What does that prat care about art? He's reading some magazine. This is the best pickup joint in London. That's what he's doing, yeah?
That is such a cynical attitude.
It's realistic. People come to art galleries for the sex. Right, see that couple in there? They're here to look at the paintings. There's nothing more boring than looking at paintings. It's the only reason anyone ever comes to an art gallery is to get laid.
I say they're interested in art.
All right, we'll do an experiment. No, come on. I'll walk that way. You walk that way. By the time we meet, I guarantee you some single man with an interest in art right, will have come up to you and gone, yes, I see you like this piece. Huh? Perhaps we can talk about it over a coffee.
Okay.
Back here, 2 minutes.
That way.
That's right.
And that was it. She just disappeared.
You have two self-obsessed friends locked into a fruitless rivalry. I don't give a care in the world about you or your well-being. So what's the problem?
We need to go back to the airport in London. Do we have time?
Half an hour.
When I found out Daniel had been in Minneapolis, I decided to meet his flight. I felt we needed to talk about Frank. I knew if I didn't get him alone, so I went to the airport. You remember I mentioned the plane had a tailwind? Well, it arrived half an hour early.
Number AIH 745 to Diana.
Sir, where are the taxis?
Far doors, follow the signs.
Thank you very much.
I'm really sorry. I did not see you standing. What the hell is happening to me? I don't know what it is happening. I'm sorry. I'm okay. Don't worry. Don't worry. It's just not my lucky day. What? <laughs> Okay. You sure you're okay? Sorry.
Excuse me, excuse me, pardon me, pardon me, sorry. Hi, I'd like you to page someone for me, please. I don't know his name, all I know is I'm supposed to meet him.
Right, well, I need his flight details, then.
I'm saying I'm supposed to meet him by that. It's just, you know, you watch a lot of sports on TV? Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, like gladiator, wrestling kind of thing. Yeah. Right, I think I need to speak to your colleague. This is kind of a woman's thing. I'm sure a man that watches a lot of sports would understand what I'm saying. Nothing
Jillian,
against you.
Would you like to deal with this customer, please?
How can I help? Hi. Have you ever seen a man, you know, a complete stranger? And that's the one. That's him.
Madam.
He's right here, and you know it.
Madam, this is an airport information desk.
I know.
We deal with lost property, flight arrival times.
I know. You don't understand what this would mean to me. Please.
Madam, I'm afraid I'm going
Give
to have to ask.
Give me that microphone. I do this in the name of sports-watching, romantically-minded men, a much maligned, misunderstood minority. Huh.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is airport information. Would a gentleman wearing a...
Brown coat and a...
Brown coat
and... Like a white T-shirt.
White shirt, T-shirt.
Khaki pants. Khaki pants.
Pair of trousers. Report to the information desk now, please.
Okay, ready. Come on, back it up. Come on back,
this No, what's going on?
Oi, can I stop? That's my car!
Sorry, lost someone.
Gentleman over there.
No. Can you try one more time, just really quick?
Well, I could.
I know, but you didn't hear.
Please, give me 2 seconds! Oh, haven't you got any compassion? No. I've only been 2 seconds!
Would a gentleman wearing a white T-shirt or shirt, khaki pants, and definitely brown shoes, or boots, please report to the information desk now, please.
Never mind. Hi. Look, you're in absolutely no condition to drive, and I need the ride to London, so why don't you get in?
You
yeah, just go around the back. Hop in. One. Can't believe I'm doing this. Okay, here's the deal. I'm gonna drive you into London. I'm gonna take you for an expensive dinner at the Black's Hotel. Do you know it?
Yeah, it's a very famous hotel.
Oh, good. So we'll eat famous lamb with mint sauce.
Okay.
Oh, I'm Martha, by the way.
Laurence. You can drive.
Yeah, good. Whoops, sorry. There you go, easy. You're all right? No, you're not. Look at you. You're not okay at all, are you, huh? Got you some ice.
Ow. No, I'm fine.
Is that better?
Ow. I'm fine, thank you.
Nice to meet you anyway. It's quite an impression you made.
Oh, really?
The blood, you know, falling into my arm.
So what do you do for a living?
I teach bridge.
Oh.
It's a card game.
Oh, so you're a gambler.
No. Actually, I mainly teach old ladies.
Ah, old ladies. So I get it. You're like a gigolo and a gambler.
No, not quite.
To be a teacher, you must be pretty good, though, huh? So when was the last time you played? Not for a while, huh? What's the matter? Aren't you good enough?
Yeah, that's exactly the problem. I'm not good enough.
Sorry.
No, don't worry.
That was really stupid. I'm sorry. You shouldn't have said that. Sometimes when I get nervous, you know, I just say the dumbest things.
When I get nervous, I never say anything. I just sit there and get uptight.
Ease your lips into a velvet kiss while I enfold you. Hands across this promised land, the seekers guided by the pole star. Say the words, why don't you say the words? I have been waiting long to hear. Please fall in love with me.
So this is London, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. You lived here all your life?
Yeah.
Yeah. What's your favorite part?
My favorite, well, it's a little corner of my local park, playing chess in the rain. There's a tiny bandstand surrounded by trees.
Oh. See, now that is a local's tip. In Minneapolis, all the visitors head straight for the Mall of America or the Viking Stadium. But the locals, there's this perfect little spot at the top of Linden Hills.
The Linden Hills.
The Linden Hills.
If I ever go, I'll remember.
Can I ask you a question? If you met a complete stranger on an airplane and he offered you an expensive hotel room, would you take it?
Probably not.
Me neither.
Thank you. Here's your bag.
Thanks. It's nice meeting you.
And you. And good luck.
You too. Wait.
What?
We made a deal, remember? You drive me into London and I take you for an expensive dinner. I mean, I still owe you, right?
Right.
Oh, hi. Hiya. Yes, I'd like to order some food. Delivery. I'd like to order a steak. Medium. And a lamb with that spicy mint sauce on the side. And some Dom Perignon. The champagne. Yes. Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you. Bye. I am sometimes catch myself thinking the most awful things, you know?
Yeah, I know what you mean.
So, what about you? Do you, you know, ever think terrible things?
Sometimes I think I should just pack up and clear out. Just go.
Go where?
Dunno. First flight anywhere. To hell with them all.
You said to hell with them all. Who's them?
Oh, my friends, for example.
Oh, who aren't really your friends at all, right? Forget your birthdays, take you for granted, talk about themselves.
Exactly.
Who else?
The person who burgled my flat 3 times in the last year.
He burgled mine, too.
The people I work for.
What about them?
Oh, they're so powdered.
And middle-aged.
And perfumed.
And lecherous.
And so spectacularly fucking untalented.
All I want to do is take a mirror and hold it up to their grotesque, sagging, surgically adjusted faces and say...
Fuck you! Get back to your wife.
Exactly.
Oh, my God. Know. What is that, London Bridge?
Albert Bridge.
Albert Bridge. Prince. Hold on. Aha! That's your service.
Very good thinking.
Yep.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh. You know, all of my life, I was told if I worked hard, stayed out of trouble, my life would be a fairy tale. In 1988, my high school gave me this plaque, you know, most likely to be successful. You know where it hangs? It's hanging by my desk in a rental car company.
Where you work for 60 hours a week?
Yeah. For a Neanderthal boss who sticks his ass on the copying machine.
So what? It all became clear in here?
Exactly. Except it was here. It was like my eyes just completely opened up, you know, like St. Paul on the road to wherever.
Damascus.
Yes, exactly. And one night I realized if I wanted to, I could just take off. Who'd miss me?
No one.
So the next morning, I picked up my check, which was a couple hundred dollars. Packed my bags, and the first flight I could afford was London. So, voila, here I am.
First flight anywhere.
Mm-hmm. Just take someone with you. Trust me, it's less scary that way.
But finding the right person, you need someone with all the right similarities, mm-hmm. yet all the right differences. Someone to read your mind instinctively.
Thanks.
Yet cover your weaknesses.
Can I ask you a question? Do you believe that things happen for a reason?
I don't understand.
Well, I'm starting to believe that nothing happens without a reason. You know, these random things that happen aren't random at all. I think things happen because they're meant to happen. Like I think I was meant to come to London, you know? Just something pulling me here. Some way or somehow there were better things in store for me.
Like what?
For the lady.
Thank you.
With the compliments of Mr. Alfred.
Thank you. Oh, wait. What was that name again?
Alfred, sir. Daniel Alfred. There's a card in the flowers. Oh, and dinner will be right with you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
be anything left in this place when I get through. They got another thing coming. Laurence?
Perfect night of your life.
And I froze. Put Daniel first, when I should have thrown away his flowers and taken her in my arms.
Yeah, but don't you see, that's what makes you so special. You were loyal to a friend. You put principles first. You took the moral high ground.
How do you explain this?
What?
Right now, she's asleep in my bed.
In your bed? Well, unless I'm very much mistaken, I think I missed something.
You remember the following day, Daniel invited us to lunch?
Yeah.
Well, it all happened then.
Laurence, help me out here. You understand these things.
Describe to Frank the perfect woman. Please.
No, you are sad.
Please. The perfect woman. Well, she'd have a light in her eyes and yes. An infectious, wonderful smile. Yes. Talking to her, you found you told her things you've never told anyone. I did that.
Began to see things
in a way you've never seen them before. Yes.
Leaving her, you knew somehow things had irreversibly changed.
Yes.
Would never be the same again.
Exactly. Thank you.
So you didn't fuck her?
Of course I didn't sleep with her.
Closing Barlow's
home. Okay, business, very nice. Thank you, good check. Maybe if you didn't piss away all the money you have,
I
should wind
up. No,
space
invasion. Punch
this line.
Away, but
I'm
dead. Oh, shut up,
both of you. You really want to hit each other. Just get it over and done with. Anything but talking about it all the time. It gives me a headache.
He was angry.
I was.
Furious. You saw Daniel was involved. The loyalty to friends always comes first, remember? What happened next?
And adding them to the number of your two longest suits.
Sorry. Hello?
Yeah, it's me. I've got her.
Who?
What do you mean, who? Her! Daniel's American.
What do you mean, got her?
Eating out of my hand. You know, pupils dilating. Can I got her?
Listen, where are you now?
In the cafe, in the park. I can't wait to tell Daniel I'm really going to enjoy this.
Frank, listen to me.
Zach, I haven't got time for a moral discussion, Florence. I just want to tell some of the good news.
Ladies, I can't explain. There's something I have to do. Something very important, and if I don't do it now, I might never forgive myself. I'm dark coat. There's another one.
What does he care about art?
This is a magazine. This is a magazine.
best pickup joint in London, this meeting. People come to our house. Sex. See that couple over there? You see how bored they are?
That is just... no.
Comes to an art gallery, it's to get laid. All right, we'll do an experiment. Come on. I'll go that way. You go that way.
Oh my God.
Oh my God. What are you doing here?
I was just.
Do you have any idea how weird this is? Us meeting like this? Aren't you pleased to see me?
Oh.
Yes, I am.
Yes, you are. No, you're not. What's wrong?
Nothing. I was just leaving.
Me too. Would you help me with my bags? You know, I could take the silence personally, but after what you told me yesterday, I'll assume that you're just nervous and I'll take that as a compliment. And whatever it is you're so angry about, just stop it. I realize I owe you an apology. I should have never accepted that hotel room. It's irresponsible. The business with the flowers and everything. What happened to your hand?
I made an omelet this morning.
You know, but they say that clumsiness is linked to your emotions.
Oh, is that right?
You'll allow me to take that as a second compliment. In the absence of any conversation, that is.
It's fools like us, always fools. By the bright side of life on the cool. How does it turn? How does it turn? Into dying embers from a love that burns. On its way to your heart somehow. On its way to your heart somehow. On its way to your heart somehow.
Wow. This is great. My apartment, I'd have to walk up 16 stories. The elevator works okay, but it's strictly for drug deals and contract fellatio.
If you want to make yourself comfy, I'll make us some tea.
Yum.
I'll be right back.
Okay.
Hello.
It's me.
Daniel, this isn't a good time.
You're right, it's a terrible time. I'm 33 years old, and I feel like a jilted teenager.
I've bunkered up on a diet of chocolate and afternoon television and books. Books
that I don't even understand.
Daniel, this really isn't...
Laurence, I hurt in places I didn't know existed.
Daniel, I said this isn't a good time.
Laurence?
It was for your card playing?
Yeah.
Thought you said you had no talent.
I don't.
Then why does it have your name on it?
Oh, my partner did all the work.
Your partner?
Hmm. He really could read people.
Oh, come on, you could do that.
I'm sorry.
Well, if someone's telling the truth or if they're lying, you know, you can learn how to read the signs. Like right now, you're still upset about something.
Oh, really?
Are these yours?
Mm-hmm.
Good. I just paid you a compliment. You could smile a little.
Thank you.
Whatever it is, it's so important. Just say it, okay? I mean, you've been like this ever since we ran into one another.
No, I haven't.
Well, then why are you looking at me like that?
Because I... you...
Because what?
Because... Will you excuse me?
Sure.
Yes!
I gave up, you know?
I no longer understand women.
Frank, this isn't a good time.
Yeah. It's a fucking terrible time.
Well, we were at the gallery. You know, she was eating out of my hand.
All of a sudden, she just like that, she just disappears all the way back to Daniel.
To Daniel?
Yeah. Oh, well, she had a heart settled him all along, didn't she?
I mean, I gave him my best shot, but credit to him. Got on well and truly.
Daniel.
Well, she told me herself, you know.
She met him at the airport, didn't she? The moment she saw him, she knew.
Something about his little brown jacket.
Khaki trousers. I didn't know he wore khaki trousers.
Florence?
Florence? Florence? Oh, don't get...
Everything okay?
Everything's fine. You just relax.
Thank you.
Laurence? Laurence?
Good morning.
Morning.
I'd like to introduce myself. I'm your neighbor from upstairs. Laurence.
How do you do?
How do you do?
It's 5:30 in the morning.
Ah.
And I have also lived here for 3 years now.
Well, welcome.
Thank you. Was there anything else?
Cup of tea might be nice.
Cup of tea?
How are we going to do this? Are you going to ask me questions or do I just talk? That's the couch, right? I want to talk about love, friendship, and deceit. I want to talk about the fact that up until 3 days ago, there were three friends.
Oh, my God.
Do you know anyone in London?
Mm-mm. Martha, by the way.
I know.
Would you take it?
Probably no. When I found out Daniel had been in Minneapolis, I decided to meet his flight.
It was a disaster that night. I didn't sleep at all.
Surprise, surprise.
I think it was fine.
Huh? He was angry.
I was. Which brings us up to date.
You have a decision to make.
Yes.
Lifelong friends on one side, a woman on the other. Perhaps the closest friends you'll ever have. Buddies through thick and thin. What's the problem? Bearing in mind there's no such thing as a difficult decision.
Sorry?
Well, every day we make hundreds of thousands of decisions. In a year, they run into tens of millions. People get themselves into knots. The truth is, decisions are easy. You know why? Because every time, we already know the answers.
You think?
Absolutely. Trade secret, always tell my boys. Oh. You see, you didn't come to see me to make a decision. You came to me because you didn't like the decision you'd already made. Sorry, Laurence. Time's up.
Thank you. I feel so good.
So am I. Well, I'm always here.
Sorry,
but
waiting.
No, that's funny. This is a psychiatrist living next door to me, and you chose to talk to me, and I'm flattered. It's been a pleasure meeting you, Laurence.
You're not. What line of work are you in? Just out of interest.
Construction.
Construction?
Hmm. You take care.
Thank you.
Martha? Ma.
Breakfast, Flower Market Cafe and Square.
Oh my God. Funny.
Florence!
Oh, what the fuck is going on?
What the fuck is he doing here?
Oh, go we've away, been set up. What are you doing here? I see. Piss off. Frank, what do you want? I'd really like to. It's obviously completely hilarious. Please go now.
This is pretty funny, huh? Hilarious. Listen, before I take off, I just need to know, does this happen all the time?
No.
These male clubs where guys pick up a girl and they set her up and they make her fall in love and then they rip the rug out from underneath her feet. Does this happen all the time or have I just been really
unlucky? Oh, no, no, I can explain.
Frank, shut up. What could you possibly explain to me? See, I'm a little bit older than six and the only people interested in you are six-year-old girls. Sorry.
Martha.
Daniel, please. You're a sweet little man. But $100 says that you took down those books and you put them right back up without reading a single one of them. Am I right?
My books?
Yeah.
Actually, I did do that, yes.
See, maybe it's me. I mean, I thought that this would be different, you know? But if you think that this is going to get me down, you're wrong. Because I'm tough. You know, I've made a decision. Changed my life, something none of you have the courage to do, none of you. I'm just gonna stand there. Do you have anything to say to me?
Yeah, well, I think I can explain if you just give me the time.
No,
please.
Ignore him.
I don't know.
I actually don't understand
why anybody would be saying this. Don't freeze on me. Don't freeze on me now, please. Please don't.
It's not quite the situation it seems to be.
Frank, shut up!
Don't tell me to shut up!
Shut up!
Don't. You are so arrogant!
What the fuck are you doing? You mean arrogant, you
arrogant
bastard!
Little wanker.
You
toddler!
Martha!
Get out of here! Bloody hell! Clean up, okay?
Laurence, I'm sorry, mate. I wasn't aware that... Don't push me!
You see? Don't push me!
You're brilliant!
Yeah? What are you going to do
about it? What am I
going
to do about it?
Ow! My arm!
Like it. See, it hurts.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Stop.
Sorry. I'm sorry.
First flight anywhere for £99.
I beg your pardon?
You have eyes in.
You have a date in mind for your return?
No return.
I beg your pardon?
I'm not coming back.
One way. Thank you.
Because there comes a point when you find the one person, the one thing that ever mattered. Oh, damn it! Instead of holding it tight, recognizing it for the priceless, most beautiful, precious gift it is. Oh! Instead of having the courage, you do what you've done all your life, You freeze. Freeze! So the truth is, whatever name you pull out of that hat, things will be a whole lot better there than they are here.
Reykjavik.
I'm sorry?
Capital of Iceland, sir. Some attractive features, I'm told. 400 miles of iceberg, long-haired sheep, and 20 hours of darkness a day. Your flight leaves at 2200 hours.
Reykjavik.
First flight, anywhere, £99.
Thank you.
Have you made a decision yet, madam?
Deny to me. Deny that it felt good. It felt good.
Yeah, it felt fucking magnificent. I feel like I've become a member of some historic male club, you know?
This is how women feel when they give birth.
Yeah. Yeah, except for the hands, probably.
Yeah, why didn't they tell you it hurt so much like that? I never knew that.
Come on.
I can't work out what he was doing then.
Who, Laurence?
Yeah. Standing there with those flowers. What were they? Peonies?
He'd probably gone for his flat.
Yeah, he's probably got a stick in his bridge trophies.
Can you imagine if he was there to meet her?
What?
Nah, she'd fuck him with two.
Yeah, she'd fuck him into tiny pieces.
Like the French actress.
Really? Does she fuck like that?
Mm. Yeah, it's these actresses, isn't it? They're always good.
Talking of which, what happened with your audition?
Well, I didn't find anyone the first time around. I'm doing a new set of auditions.
Well, that's terrific. I hope you go.
Yeah, I'll go. I'm gonna stand up on the stage, look out, go, like me, like me, like me!
excuse me, a moment, sir. You're the 100,000th passenger to fly in this airline this year.
Right.
And to mark the occasion, the airline would like to fly you first class.
First class.
Would you like another drink? Thank you.
Here we go, sir. First class. Here's your seat down here.
Would either of you like another drink?
Are you sure this is,
Yes, yes.
Iceland, huh? Amsterdam, that's like not even
40 minutes. I know he didn't recommend it.
Well, we have all the time in the world.
Yeah.
isn't she?